Hello students, in the last video we have discussed about muscular tissues, which includes mainly three types, such as skeletal muscular tissue or skeletal muscle fiber, cardiac muscle fiber and smooth muscle fiber. In this class, let us discuss about nervous tissues, the last type of animal tissue, that is nervous tissue. Nervous tissues are specialized in reception, integration and transmission of stimuli or impulses to different parts of the body. Nervous system are specialized in receiving the signals or in receiving the stimuli, impulses, messages, integration and transmission, receiving, integrating and transmitting the stimuli or messages or impulses to different parts of the body. All living organisms are able to respond to the stimuli. Response to the stimuli is one of the defining characteristic feature of living organism. That means all the living organisms respond to the stimuli. In case of human beings, well-developed nervous system is present, which receives the stimuli and transmit the stimuli either to the brain or to the spinal cord, where processing takes place. Then the brain or spinal cord send the responsory stimulus to the particular part of the body. After receiving the impulses or stimuli only, body parts shows particular type of actions. It may be, response may be in the form of movement, response may be in the form of bending of the body or stretching of the body, etc. All these are the responses to the stimuli. In case of nervous system or in case of nervous system, the nervous tissues are devoid of a matrix. Matrix is absent in the nervous tissues. The cells of the nervous tissues are surrounded by special connective tissue cells. The cells of the nervous system are surrounded or covered by special connective tissue cells. Nervous tissue and its connective tissue cells combines to form brain, spinal cord and nerves. Brain, spinal cord and nerves together constitutes nervous system of a human body. And the nervous system of the human body contains nervous tissues and which is surrounded by the connective tissue cells. Together forms either nerves or brain or spinal cord. Individual cells of the nervous tissue. Individual cells of the nervous tissue are called as neurons or nerve cells. Nerve cells or neurons are the individual cells of the nervous tissue. Tissue is nothing but group of cells. Nervous tissue is containing many nerve cells. That nerve cells are also called as neurons. And neurons are the structural and functional unit of nervous system. Neurons are the structural and functional unit of nervous system. See, this is the structure of neuron. Structure of neuron. Draw a neat label diagram of neuron or explain the structure of neuron with neat label diagram is important. See, this is the structure of neuron. Neuron structure mainly contains three parts, such as cell body, dendrites and axon. cell body, dendrites and axon are the important three structures present in the neuron. Cell body, see, this is the cell body. This is cell body and these are dendrites. These are dendrites. This one is the cell body. Cell body is polygonal, broader and nucleated part of the neuron. Cell body is polygonal shaped and it is broader and contains nucleus. Only in the cell body nucleus is present. And cell body has all different types of structures, but centriole is absent. Centriole is absent. Other than centriole, all the structures are present in the cell body, but in the cell body, centriole is absent. Because of the absence of centriole only, these neurons cannot divide. They cannot divide. If a particular neuron is damaged, then the number of neurons will be reduced by one in the body of a human beings. Because these neurons cannot undergo division because of the absence of centriole. And in the cell body, or it is also called as cyton, C-Y-T-O-N, cyton or soma, S-O-M-A. In the cell body, nasal granules are present. Nasal granules are present and other than this nasal granules, some neurofibrils are present. Cell body contains nucleus, then nasal granules and neurofibrils. Neurofibrils. Neurofibrils are the very small fibrils which are helpful in the transmission of impulses or transmission of messages. Next structure is the dendrite. Dendrites. Dendrites are small. These are small, tapering, branched protoplasmic outgrowth of the cell body. Small, tapering, branched protoplasmic outgrowth. Protoplasmic outgrowth of the cell body. That means dendrites arises from the cell body. And these dendrites are also called as dendrons. Dendrites are also called as dendrons. The main function of dendrites is receiving the impulses and transmitting the impulses towards the cell body. Dendrites receives impulses or messages from other neurons or from other tissues of the body, and then they transmit the same impulses towards the cyton or towards the cell body. The main function of dendrite is the receiving impulses and transmitting the impulses towards cell body. Another structure is called axon. Axon. Axon is a long fiber-like structure. Axon is a long fiber-like structure and usually it arises singly from the cell body. Axon is a long fiber-like structure which usually arises singly from the cell body. And in case of axon, nasal granules are absent. Nasal granules are present in the cell body, but these nasal granules are absent in the axon. Axon are devoid of nasal granules. But axon contains neurofibrils. Means neurofibrils are present in both cell body and in axon. But nasal granules are absent in axon. The main function of axon is it carries the impulses or messages away from the cell body. Dendrites transmit the impulses towards the cell body, whereas the axon transmit the impulses away from the cell body. And axon sometimes is surrounded by a sheath. It is surrounded by a sheath, and that sheath is called as myelin sheath. Sometimes axons are surrounded by a sheath called myelin sheath. Sometimes these sheaths are absent. And myelin sheath contains special connective tissue cells, and the connective tissue myelin sheath is secreted by the special connective tissue cells called Schwann cells. See, these are Schwann cells which secrete the myelin sheath. And axon at the end or at the terminal side, axon is branched into fine branches, that is called nerve endings. Axon is divided terminally into fine branches. So these are the fine branches which are present at the terminal end of the axon. That is called nerve endings. This is about the structure of neuron. And the main function of nervous system is, main functions of nervous system or nervous tissues are, first one is, nervous tissues receive the sensations or sensory impulses of all types. For example, it receives the impulses of sound, smell, taste, touch, pain, etc. Then another function is, nervous system provides responses to all types of stimuli. They provide response to all types of stimuli. Nervous system exerts control over all body activities. They control all the activities of the body. Nervous system also coordinates the functioning of different body parts. They coordinate the functioning of different body parts. For example, nervous tissue brings coordination between the muscular tissues, between the respiratory system, circulatory system, etc. For example, when we are running, at that time our leg muscles requires more and more energy. That energy is produced by aerobic respiration, means production of energy in the presence of oxygen. For the production of more oxygen, body cells requires more oxygen, that will be supplied by increasing the rate of respiration. For the production of more energy, body cells requires more and more oxygen. That more oxygen will be supplied by increasing the rate of respiration. When the rate of respiration increases, the rate of pumping of blood by the heart also increases. Then only it can, heart or blood can supply more oxygen to the muscle cells. So like this, nervous system sends the message to particular organs of the body and coordinates the functioning of different parts of the body. This is about functions of nervous system and the structure of neurons. This completes your tissues chapter. Thank you.